होमोमॉर्फिज्म एंड आइसोमॉर्फिज्म ऑफ ग्रोथ्स. मॉर्फिज्म्स आर मैपिंग विच प्रिजर्व स्ट्रक्चर. मॉर्फिज्म्स आर सेटअप और अप्लाइड बिटवीन टू लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स. डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ मॉर्फिज्म्स आर होमोमॉर्फिज्म, आइसोमॉर्फिज्म, मोनोमॉर्फिज्म, एपिमॉर्फिज्म, एंडोमॉर्फिज्म, ऑटोमॉर्फिज्म. Now we'll define what is into homomorphism or homomorphism into. Let G and G dash be two groups and F be a mapping from G into G dash. That is, F is a function from G to G dash. If for A comma B belong to G, F of A into B is equals to F of A into F of B, then F is said to be a homomorphism from G into G dash. The dot on the left hand side of 1 indicates the composition in G, and the dot on the right hand side indicates the composition in G dash. Generally, we omit writing dot in equation number 1. That is, in this F of A dot B equal to F of A and F of B, we generally omit dot. That is, F is a function from G to G dash such that F of A into B is equal to F of A and F of B for all A comma B belong to G. This is an into homomorphism or simply homomorphism. Now we'll define what is endomorphism. A homomorphism of a group into itself is called an endomorphism. That is, the domain set and the codomain set both are the same. In a homomorphism, if the domain group and codomain group both are the same, then that type of morphism is called endomorphism. That is, F from G to G, such that F of A into B is equal to F of A into F of B for all A comma B belong to G. That is, here we consider only one group, that is G alone. Now we define what is onto homomorphism. Let G and G dash be two groups and F be a function from G on to G dash. Here the function is on to. If for A comma B belong to G, F of A into B is equal to F of A into F of B, then F is said to be a homomorphism from G on to G dash. The only difference between into homomorphism and onto homomorphism is onto homomorphism onto function, whereas in into homomorphism the function is simply a function. G dash is said to be homomorph or homomorphic image of G. That is, in onto homomorphism, the codomain set G dash is said to be homomorphic image of G. We write this as F of G equals to G dash. That is, here the codomain set and the range set both are the same. In this case, we write the algebraic structure G comma dot is homomorphic to the algebraic structure G dash dot, or G is homomorphic to G dash. This is a symbol for homomorphic epimorphism. On to homomorphism is sometimes called epimorphism. Monomorphism. If the homomorphic into is 1, 1, then it is called monomorphism. Isomorphism. Let G and G dash be two groups and F be a 1-to-1 mapping from G on to G dash. That is, here the function is a bijective function because it is both 1-1 and on to. It is both injective and subjective. Therefore, here the function f is a bijective mapping. If for a comma b belong to G, f of a into b is equal to f of a, f of b, then f is said to be an isomorphism from G to G dash. In this case, we say that G is isomorphic to G dash, and we write it as G is isomorphic to G dash. This symbol is for isomorphism. That is, f is from G to G dash such that f of a into b equal to f of a and f of b for all a comma b belong to G is both 1 to 1 and on to. That is, 1 to 1 on to homomorphism is an isomorphism. Thus, a function which satisfies the condition f of ab is equal to f of a and f of b is known as into homomorphism. A function is 1-1 and satisfying the condition f of ab is equal to f of a and f of b, that is called monomorphism. A function which satisfies f of a into b is equal to f of a and f of b and the function is onto, that is called homomorphism onto. If a function which satisfies the condition f of a into b equal to f of a and f of b and the function is 1-1 onto, then that function is called isomorphism. Or a function which is 1-1 and onto satisfying the condition f of a into b equal to f of a and f of b is known as isomorphism. Let g and g dash be two groups and f is a function from g to g dash such that f of a into b is equal to f of a into f of b for all a comma b belong to g, then f is an into homomorphism. Let g be a group and f be a function from g to g, that is itself, such that f of a into b is equal to f of a into f of b for all a comma b belong to g, then f is an endomorphism. Let g and g dash be two groups and f be a function from g on to g dash, that is the range set is equals to codomain set, such that f of a into b is equal to f of a into f of b for all a comma b belong to g, then f is called an onto homomorphism. Let g and g dash be two groups, f be an onto function from g to g dash such that f of a into b is equal to f of a into f of b for all a comma b belong to g, then f is an epimorphism. That is, onto homomorphism is also known as epimorphism. Let g and g dash be two groups and f be a 1-to-1 function from g to g dash such that f of a into b is equal to f of a into f of b for all a comma b belong to g, then f is called a monomorphism. Let g and g dash be two groups and f be a 1-to-1 and onto function from g to g dash such that f of a b is equal to f of a into f of b for all a comma b belong to g, then f is called an isomorphism. Here the function f is a bijective function, that is, it is 1-1 and onto, that is injective and surjective. Let g be a function and f be a 1-1 onto function from g to g, that is g itself, such that f of a comma b is equal to f of a into f of b for all a comma b belong to g, then f is called an automorphism. Distinction between isomorphism and homomorphism. The isomorphic mapping should be necessarily 1-1 and onto, satisfying the condition for all a comma b belong to G, f of a into b is equals to f of a into f of b, whereas a homomorphic, that is onto homomorphism mapping, need not be necessarily 1-1. It may be many to 1. The relation of isomorphic in the set of groups is an equivalence relation, but the relation of homomorphism will not be an equivalence relation, because the relation of homomorphism will not be symmetric, as we know that only 1 to 1 on to mapping are invertible. In other words, if G is homomorphic to G dash, then G dash need not be homomorphic to G. Whereas G is isomorphic to G dash implies G dash is isomorphic to G. If the group G is finite, then G can be isomorphic to G dash only if G dash is also finite and the number of elements in G is equal to the number of elements in G dash. Otherwise, there will exist no mapping from G to G dash, which is 1 to 1 and on 2. Examples. Let I comma plus be a group where I is set of integers. Define a mapping F from the set of integers I to the set of integer I such that F of x is equal to k into x for all x belong to I and k is an integer. This is a domain set I, this is a codomain set I. Here f is a function. Now it is defined as f of x is equals to k into x. Is f be a homomorphism? Yes, f is a homomorphism because for all x comma y belong to z, x plus y belongs to z. Here z is nothing but set of integers capital I, and f of x plus y, here plus being the binary operation, we have taken x plus y, that is f of x plus y is equals to k into x plus y. This is by definition of f of x, because f of x is equals to k into x. In the place of x, we are having x plus y. Therefore, f of x plus y is equal to k into x plus y. That is equals to k into x plus k into y. What is the value of k into x? The value of k into x is f of x. Similarly, the value of k into y is f of y. Therefore, this equals to f of x plus f of y. It is true for all x comma y belong to I. Therefore, f of x plus y is equal to f of x plus f of y. Therefore, f is a homomorphism of a group I into itself. That is, f is an endomorphism in I. The second example, f is a function from set of complex numbers to set of complex numbers C, defined by f of x plus I y is equals to I into y. If you consider any complex numbers here, the image of the complex number is nothing but the imaginary part, that is I into y. Is f a homomorphism? Let z1 is equal to x1 plus I into y1 and z2 is equals to x2 plus I into y2, where x1 and x2 are real parts, y1 and y2 are imaginary part, where z1 and z2 belong to the set of complex numbers, where x1, x2, y1 and y2 are real numbers. What is z1 plus z2? that is equals to x1 plus I into y1 plus x2 plus I into y2. When you add two complex numbers, we have to add real parts separately and imaginary parts separately. Therefore, the sum is equals to x1 plus x2, that is the real part, plus I into imaginary part, namely y1 plus y2. Since here addition being the binary operation, let us consider f of z1 plus z2, that is equals to f of z1 plus z2 value is x1 plus x2 plus I into y1 plus y2. Therefore, this f of a complex number, by the definition of a function f of x plus iy, we have to write I into imaginary part. Therefore, f of x1 plus x2 plus I into y1 plus y2, we have to write only I into the imaginary part, that is I into y1 plus y2. Let us multiply I into y1 plus I into y2. What is I into y1? I into y1 will be f of x1 plus I into y1. What is iy2? Iy2 is f of x2 plus I into y2. What is x1 plus I into y1? That is z1. What is x2 plus I into y2? That is z2. Therefore, this is equals to f of z1 plus f of z2. Thus, f of z1 plus z2 is equals to f of z1 plus f of z2. Therefore, f is a homomorphism of a group c comma plus into itself, that is f is an entomorphism in c. The third example, let g be a multiplicative group with identity a. Let us define a mapping f from g to g such that f of x is equals to a for all x belong to g. That is, image of any element of the group g will be always mapped into the identity element of the group g. That is, this is a domain set g, this is a codomain set g, both are groups, g and g both are groups, this is a domain group, this is a codomain group. F is a function here. Suppose you have elements a, b, c, d, e, x, y, z in the group g. What is the image of a under the function f? That is f of a. What is f of a? That is equal to e. The image of b under f is f of b equal to e. What is f of c? E. What is f of e? E. What is f of x? E. That is, every element of g is mapped into of e, where the e is the identity element. Now we have to check whether this function f is a homomorphism or not. For a comma b belong to g, a into b also belongs to g by closure axiom. Therefore, f of a equals to e, f of b equal to e, this by definition. Now, f of ab is equals to, by definition, f of x is equal to e. Whatever element of g is here, f of that element is equal to e. Since ab is an element of g, f of a into b is equal to e by definition. E can be written as e into e. This e can be written as f of a. This e can be written as f of b. Thus, f of a into b is equals to f of a into f of b. Therefore, f is a homomorphism of a group g into g itself, that is, f is an entomorphism in g. So this is a constant function because the image is a singleton set, which is a constant function, and every element is mapped into the identity element of g, and this function is endomorphism. This function is a homomorphism of a group g to itself. The fourth example, let G be an additive group of integers, that is G equals to I or capital Z. Define a mapping F from G to G such that F of A equal to A plus 2 for all A belong to G. What is F of B? It is B plus 2. What is F of 8? It is 8 plus 2, 10. What is F of 0? F of 0 will be 0 plus 2 is 2. What is F of minus 3? F of minus 3 will be minus 3 plus 2 is minus 1. What is F of minus 10? Minus 10 plus 2 is minus 8. This is how we define the function. Now let us check whether this function is a homomorphism or not. Let us consider the domain group G. This is a codomain group G. F is a function. Here the function is defined as F of A equals to A plus 2. For A comma B belong to G, A plus B also belongs to G by closure axiom, because here the operation is addition. Therefore, we take A plus B belongs to G. Then by definition, since A and B are elements of G, A belongs to G implies F of A equal to A plus 2. B belongs to G implies F of B equals to B plus 2. This is by definition of the function F. Now consider F of A plus B, because the operation is addition. Otherwise, we take A into B. So F of A plus B is equals to, for any element of G, its image will be that element plus 2. Here, what is the element? A plus B is an element. And A plus B is the element of G. Therefore, F of A plus B equals to A plus B plus 2. That can be written as A plus 2 plus B. What is A plus 2? F of A. What is B? Is it F of B? No. Therefore, the above one, namely A plus 2 plus B, is not equals to F of A plus F of B, because F of A plus F of B will be A plus 2 plus B plus 2, that is equal to A plus B plus 4. But you are getting here A plus B plus 2. And hence F of A plus B is not equal to F of A plus F of B. Therefore, F is not a homomorphism.